We are introduced to the children of Hiccup and Astrid when their family sails towards the entrance to the hidden world years after Toothless and the dragons disappeared. But since these kids only had a few moments with us, were the culmination of Hiccup and Astrid's relationship, and were the future of Berk, I had to learn everything I could about them. Hello, I'm Isaac from Wotso Videos, where we discuss fun topics for fun people. On my channel, I focus on spreading magic by examining animated, mostly Disney films, so if you are new here, consider subscribing. For 300 years, the Hooligan tribe lived on the Isle of Berk until Chief Hiccup led his people to a new land, which they called New Berk, in hopes of avoiding the war on the dragons that was being raged. Inevitably, though, battles were fought between the Hooligan tribe and the Dragon Hunter and Warlord Alliance, which ended in Hiccup's forces, which included dragons and New Berkians alike, to rise above them. After the battle, all of the dragons of the world disappeared to the hidden world, while Hiccup led the Hooligan tribe into a new era with the help of his wife, Astrid. Hiccup and Astrid's journey to fall in love was long, complicated, and filled with the natural ups and downs of relationships, and honestly, I have loved watching them grow together. Their journey to be partners was incredible, and their bond feels so intimate and strong, which is why it was so exciting to see the existence of their children. To see how Astrid and Hiccup began to date and became betrothed, definitely check out my videos on both of those topics linked in the description. On the day Hiccup reunited with Toothless, we are able to see the children of Hiccup and Astrid. The first was their firstborn son, who was named Nuffink, while the second was their firstborn child, and was known as Zephyr. By examining his appearance, Nuffink seems to have inherited Astrid and Hiccup's thin and lanky body, but he has Astrid's blonde hair and Hiccup's green eyes and shaggy hair. Nuffink sets himself apart though by having a few small braids in the back of his hair and wears a light tan long-sleeved shirt with a decorative lining on the end of his sleeve and a belt with a Night Fury head on the buckle. He also wears a necklace with a set of three sharp teeth on it, which likely derived from dragons during the years where they lived amongst the Berkians. Even though the dragons had left, Nuffink still wore their symbols that represented embodying acting fierce, strong, and protective, likely because he too exhibited and would soon take on these traits, for the truth was that much like his mother, Nuffink was a warrior by heart. In the book The Art of How to Train Your Dragon: The Hidden World, Nuffink is described as having his mother's personality, being adventurous and turbulent. While his timidness and shyness may not make him seem like he could be extremely courageous, due to his young age and his mother's uncertainty of dragons at first as well, this was likely what caused him to freeze initially at the sight of a Night Fury. More often, he's ready to fight, face who wronged him, and be unrelenting, like Astrid. In the years to come, especially under Astrid's watchful eye, Nuffink will surely rise to be a great warrior in New Berk. Nuffink's older sister, Zephyr, on the other hand, was much more like her father. Again, in the book, The Art of How to Train Your Dragon: The Hidden World, she is described as having her father's nervous personality and a desire to document everything she observed. To do this, Zephyr carried notebooks around with her like her father had while he traveled the world. While Zephyr does appear to be close to Astrid, seen through her mimicking her mother's actions of pulling on the ship's ropes, her ability to trust the seemingly wild creatures around her, in addition to all of her similarities to her father, make her extremely similar to Hiccup. While her personality mirrors that of Hiccup and her brown hair does as well, Zephyr has inherited her mother's blue eyes and her heart-shaped face. Zephyr also wears her hair and is dressed in clothing that resembles Astrid's early years, since she wears a sleeveless tunic in a grayish or dark blue or green color, a large red sash, and a reddish-brown leather skirt with blunt metal studs on it. She also donned a crancen like Astrid. A Viking crancen has a Nordic definition roughly meaning head wreath, which was an accessory worn by unmarried girls during special occasions. In this case, the meeting of the dragons that bonded with their parents was the moment that allowed her to wear the crancen. Traditionally, a crancen was passed down from mother to daughter, so a single crancen could last for many generations in Viking culture. But by the way Astrid is wearing one herself, the women of Berk seem to not follow this tradition seriously. As the firstborn child of the chief of Berk, whose name translated to mean the West Wind, she is the embodiment of the future of her people who had once came from the east and traveled west. She's not only the most likely to be the next chief, though, but could be the Hooligan tribe's first female heir. During Hiccup's youth, when he and his father Stoic were having their portrait painted, Stoic explained the significance of the art that was being created. They were going to be immortalized with all the former chiefs and their sons. So maybe Zephyr will be breaking a long-standing tradition of firstborn sons rising to be chief. A new order will be established under Zephyr as she becomes the first Hooligan chief born on New Berk and will rise to be the first woman chief. But while she will bring a new perspective to the leadership position, she will likely respect the tradition her father and the chiefs before her established. I think she will begin by following in the footsteps of Hiccup while also forging her own path as a leader. At some point in the future, I believe both of these children of the great Astrid and Hiccup will seize their destiny to become truly great individuals for New Berk. Sure, we only were able to witness Zephyr and Nuffink when they were young, innocent, and opening up to the creatures their parents had grown to love during their youth at the entrance of the hidden world. But I'm sure with the guidance of Hiccup and Astrid, they will grow to be strong, powerful, and influential people who push the Hooligan tribe to continue to thrive into the future. While one I think will channel their warrior spirit to become a hero, the other I think will learn to lead to become a historic chief. But now it's time to hear your thoughts. Who do you think Zephyr and Nuffink will become? And more generally, what did you think of the ending of the third How to Train Your Dragon movie? Let me know what you think in the comments along with any other ideas you have for future videos. To see more How to Train Your Dragon videos like this one, you can find a link to those videos in the description. And if you'd like to continue to see more magical discussions like this one, then don't forget to click that subscribe button and the beautiful bell if you're new. Thank you to my wonderful patrons over on Patreon who are amazing supporters of my videos. And as always, thanks for watching and have a magical day.